Y'all get ready.
Yes, you get ready.
Shout out to all my tea sippers out there. We are gathered here today to sip some tea, honey. So make sure you guys have your teacups ready because you already know this tea is what? Piping hot. All right, so you guys know what that means, okay? We have another story concerning the Pissy Pied Piper. So what's going down right now is that one of the girls, you know, one of the so-called girls who've been held hostage, who can't leave the apartment, he's been sliding porridge under her damn door too. Asriel Clary's living her best damn life, honey. She's having a true hot girl summer now that R. Kelly's ass is in jail. I'm sure if R. Kelly was out and he saw all this foolishness that Asriel Clary was posting on social media, he'd be puffing on his big ass cigar and choking, okay? Exhibit A, check it out. Alright, y'all just seen R. Kelly choking on that big ass cigar. So anyways, this entire situation is a hot mess. So as we all know, we're usually used to seeing Jocelyn Savage and Asriel Clary basically dressed in damn turtlenecks, you know what I'm saying, and long pants even in the summertime. R. Kelly doesn't want to show off their bodies, but yet and still he paid for them to get a ton of plastic surgery. Both girls were blessed with new boobs, a slim waist, and a fat ass, okay? So he pays for surgery, but then he doesn't want nobody else looking at them besides him. Well, now that he's been locked up, Asriel is taking full advantage. She's out here trying to decide what to wear. She's showing off her Snapchat. She's wilding on the gram, and then got the nerve to have an attitude when people send these videos to the Shade Room and folks start dragging her on the Shade Room. So this entire situation is crazy, honey, but you know what? I'm here for it, bitch. Y'all go ahead and check out these videos. I'm gonna come back with the rest of my commentary.
Okay, so this is for whoever thought they was doing something by posting my story on the Shade Room and screenshotting it. Okay, first of all, I've always had a fucking phone, so I don't get it where people think, oh my gosh, she has a phone, wow. No, I've always had a phone. Just because my parents put it out there that I don't have a phone, that's them. I don't talk to my parents. I'm not in communication with my parents, and I don't want to talk with my parents. I'm a grown-ass woman, 21, about to be 22, and if I don't want to talk to my parents, I don't have to talk to my parents. I don't have to talk to nobody in this fucking world if I don't want to. This is exactly why I don't post on social media, because people are going to say what they want. People are going to take whatever they want and turn it into whatever they want. But at the end of the day, let it be known that I am definitely in love. For my parents saying, oh my God, I want you to be happy. I want my child to be happy. I'm happy with R. Kelly, so let me live my fucking life. Like, let me live my life. First of all, only reason I was trying on stuff is because it's Justin's birthday and we're out and we're celebrating for her. And like, literally, even before Robert was locked up, we were gonna celebrate anyways. Literally 1 month ago, I was in Florida doing hookah, turning up, living my life, and that's when I was with Robert. Okay, so for people saying, oh, she's held hostage, she can't do this, she can't do that, no, yes.
All right, so you guys just saw the videos of Asriel Clary going off and then also saying that, you know, she's grown. She's 21 going on 22. She's living her best life. She doesn't talk to her parents, doesn't care what her parents say. She's been had a phone and all this other stuff. So her father finally decided to speak out. And you could tell, you know, he's happy to see his daughter, but there's still a lot of hurt there. And I can kind of stomach the Clarys a lot better than the Savages. I'm not going to lie. The Clarys, yeah, they did kind of hand their daughter off to R. Kelly too to, you know, give them a music career and all that stuff. But they seem to carry themselves a lot better than the Savages. That's just my personal opinion. So I can stomach her father a lot more. Y'all go ahead and check out what he had to say. Check this out, and I'm going to come back with the rest of my commentary.
My baby girl. Some may say, damn, look at her. She's showing out this and that and being inappropriate. But, man, what I see is a young woman now that left as a young lady. And now she just acting out. Look at the freedom. Look at her. Don't judge her. Look at her actions. She free. I love you, ass. Your daddy love you a lot. Look at my baby.
All right, so you guys just saw what Mr. Cleary had to say about his daughter. And like he's saying, he doesn't want to judge her. She looks like a young girl who's happy. She's finally finding some freedom. And I'm just glad, you know, being a parent myself, that he's at least able to see his daughter. She looks healthy. She looks well-fed. You know, people are saying that she's brainwashed and all this other stuff. I'm no psychiatrist, honey, okay? I don't have a degree in psychology. You know, I don't even know. Maybe she's brainwashed, or maybe she really feels like, you know what? She's living good. I mean, think about it. She's living in Trump Towers and, you know, dressed to the nines and flying here and flying there. And her and the other young girl, Jocelyn Savage, they've gotten comfortable with that lifestyle. They've gotten comfortable with that money. And that's one thing I've been saying from day one. You know what I'm saying? The parents cannot offer these daughters the same lifestyle that R. Kelly was able to offer them. Hence why they're not going home, okay? And that was my whole issue with all these other so-called R. Kelly victims. They ran to him in 2016, 2017, 2018 because they wanted that lifestyle, okay? Everybody knew he was a damn pervert. But like I said, when you're 30 something years old and you're willing to quit your radio job to go be one of R. Kelly's girlfriends, I'm not gonna shed boohoo tears for you, because you obviously had nefarious intentions as well, okay? But what Asriel needs to realize is that you only have one mother and you only have one father. And both these parents clearly miss their child. They want some type of relationship with them. And once R. Kelly is found guilty, which I believe he will be found guilty because he's done a lot of fuck shit. Like I said, there are definitely real victims in this situation. And I stand by that, but I will not shed any tattooed tears for the attention whores. Period, point blank. Y'all can take that how the fuck y'all want to take it. That's my opinion. Now, as far as the real victims go, I do believe that he will be tried and convicted because he has done a lot of just horrible things to a lot of young women, okay? So once that money runs out, once that lifestyle is over, what will you young ladies have to fall back on? And that's the thing that really saddens me, because they've gotten very comfortable with this lifestyle. Will they be hopping from celebrity man to celebrity man, you know what I'm saying, and possibly get pimped out and pass through the industry? Or will they go home to their parents? Because this little fantasy world that they're living in is about to bust soon enough. You know, and they need to wake up and realize that. The parents want them home. Granted, they're grown. They don't have to go home. But they need to realize that once R. Kelly goes away, then what? Then where will you be? You have no education to fall back on. You have no musical career. Right now, you guys are the joke of the damn shade room, okay? So I just find this really, really sad that this is how she's carrying on. You know, again, it could be Stockholm Syndrome, or it could be, you know, I'm living a comfortable damn life and I know a comfortable roof over my head when I see one. You know, it could be one of the two. But in other damn R. Kelly news, okay, if you guys do not know, his crisis manager, the one that Tim Savage was yelling at, the one he was like, where's my daughter? Get my daughter. Yeah, that one. Well, grand opening, grand motherfucking closing, okay? So what's going down is this. Mr. Daryl Johnson went on to CBS in the morning yesterday, and he basically said that he would not even allow his 20-year-old daughter to be left alone with R. Kelly, okay? So if you're the crisis manager, you wouldn't even allow your child to be with the damn, you know, pervert. I just found that really funny. Well, once that clip went viral and people were dragging him, he mysteriously decided to resign, okay? So he is no longer R. Kelly's crisis manager. He quit the same day he's made that statement. So this entire situation is crazy. Y'all go ahead and check this out, and I'm gonna come back with the rest of my commentary.
Just hours after appearing only on CBS This Morning, singer R. Kelly's crisis manager resigned. In a statement to CBS News, Daryl Johnson said he is stepping down for, quote, personal reasons, and he did not elaborate. Daryl Johnson, I should say.
That's right. Daryl. Yesterday on CTM, Johnson made headlines when he said he would not leave his 20-something daughter alone with anyone accused of being a pedophile. R. Kelly is charged with sexually abusing women and girls. You have a 20-something-year-old daughter. Would you allow her to be alone with
Absolutely not.
With R. Kelly?
I wouldn't leave my daughter with anybody that's accused of pedophilia.
That doesn't seem like a contradiction to you. You're
absolutely
sitting here defending R. Kelly, but at the same time saying you wouldn't leave your own daughter with him.
I wouldn't leave my daughter with anyone. Okay. I'm going to say it again. That's accused of being a pedophile.
All right. R. Kelly is currently being held without bond after his arrest earlier this month on federal sex crime charges in Illinois and New York. You could almost say it was a case of the crisis manager creating a crisis. I talked to Daryl last night. He said he was not asked to step down, but he's stepping down, he says, for personal reasons because he believes he could become a distraction to R. Kelly's case. He believes in R. Kelly. He believes in this whole process. And he says at the end of the day, the courts will decide.
Yeah.
But no one asked him to leave, he said.
No, it certainly seemed like he came to a realization at our table
what was being alleged.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden it dawned on him.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, so you guys just saw what Daryl Johnson had to say, and you guys also saw what Gayle King had to say as well. So this entire situation is crazy. So right now, R. Kelly is currently awaiting a federal trial on 18 counts, including child pornography. So now that the feds are involved, I don't see R. Kelly getting away. I don't. And my thing is, I don't feel bad for him because you got away the first time, just like OJ. And instead of, you know what I'm saying, thanking your lucky stars, okay, that you got away with some shit that you were definitely guilty of, you got more arrogant, you got more complacent, you got more comfortable. But like they always say, the devil comes home to collect. So R. Kelly will be going down for this. And the people who aided and abetted him, who recruited other girls, who thought everything was all good as long as they was getting a check, all y'all should go down with him as well. And I stand by that statement wholeheartedly. There's a lot of guilty people in this situation, not just R. Kelly. So anyways, y'all, let's go ahead and get the discussion popping. Go ahead and leave a comment. Let me know your thoughts on this entire messy situation, honey. Once again, concerning Azriel Clary, honey, just living her hot girl summer, refusing to get off the damn gram and Snapchat. And then how do you guys feel about R. Kelly's crisis manager quitting one day after he stated that he would not allow his daughter to be left alone with R. Kelly? So let's go ahead and get the discussion popping. Go ahead and leave a comment. All right. Deuces.